everyone, this is Arcadius, and welcome back to Naval Creed. Today, we will be reviewing the fourth and final, that current free XP ship that is in the game, the HMS Tiger. Now, this is a pretty low-tier ship at matchmaking 5, but she does have her benefits, though they may be few. So, let's start off with the pros. She is the ship with the most health at this tier, at 57,000. There are some ships, such as the French battleship, that start off with only about 40,000, so she has almost 33% more health than some of the other ships, or battleships and battlecruisers at this tier. Additionally, she has the third farthest range of 17.3 kilometers, with a secondary range of 4 kilometers as well. She is also quite fast at 27.5 knots, however, she's not the fastest. She is beaten by Congo, which can go 30 knots. However, she can go a little bit over 30 knots with the speed boost. She can go about 30.2. So not a major difference. She has four double 343mm guns. And these aren't necessarily bad. They're relatively accurate. Armor piercing is good. That's what I mainly use. High explosive can be used. And I assume it's good. Like I said, I haven't used it very often, but when I have used it in the past, I do usually get a fire or two when I do use it. The fire percent chance is 38.3, so it's relatively good. Shell velocity of 759 meters per second, pretty good. And so the guns themselves are good. So let's go to the secondaries. There's six 6-inch guns on each side. They do only shoot up to 4 kilometers, like I said earlier. However, they are relatively good against destroyers, but the range that you have to be for them to be effective against destroyers, you're probably sucking on some torpedoes by that point anyways. But you can get up to 2,500 to 3,000 damage on destroyers at point-blank range. Anything other than destroyers, they're practically useless. AA. She's not the worst AA ship at this tier, but she's certainly not the best. She has 13 damage per second at a range of 4 kilometers, which is only worse by the other British battlecruiser at this tier that has 12 at 4 kilometers. So you're not a big AA platform, though you can surprisingly still shoot down a couple planes in your games. They compose of two guns here on each side and one gun here on each side, and that is your AA defense. So carriers will be licking their chops when they see you, because you're a big target, you're really, really big, you can see the size of the ship, and you can't maneuver and you can't shoot down their aircraft pretty much at all. She is good speed-wise. Maneuverability, though, is kind of lacking. She does have a pretty long movement time is 17.5 seconds. She does take quite a bit of time to turn. She does come with heal and the speed boost, like I mentioned. And then just the normal repair as well. I do want accuracy on her at this time, mainly because with her great range, you can use her as a long-range sniper, similar to how Congo is. And I enjoy that playstyle. And so I stay at range because anything else you can't really defend against. You don't have the secondaries or the AA to really defend yourself. You only have your guns, and those are best used at range. Her armor, belt of 229, it does have a slight turtleback, if you can kind of see it here. And your armor is pretty good. You do struggle to citadel this ship. However, you do take massive pen damage because you have just such a flat broadside that you can easily take quite a bit of damage at any kind of angle. With that, let's toss her into a game and see how she does. Anyways, to have ourselves a game. Three battleships, one cruiser, three destroyers. So not the best game, not the best map, but it'll still show how this ship plays. I do have some health buffs and some speed buffs, so my ship has more health and is faster than normal. And with that, we're off. All right off the bat, you can kind of see she's slow to accelerate. I don't have much crew skills on the ship, if any, at this point. So she is pretty much base, besides the few buffs I have applied. The gun angles are relatively good, however, the gun rotation is pretty slow. That is why I run accuracy, though you could definitely go for gun rotation and reload. At this angle, if you aim towards the bow area, you would take a lot of pen damage, but on the broadside itself, you would hopefully be able to ricochet most of any incoming shots. Now, I do start off with armor piercing, mainly because high explosive at range is kind of questionable, and high explosive in general is questionable to me. The armor piercing is just so powerful at this tier that you don't really need to use high explosive. Though I guess it's best used against carriers. Nice grouping, high shell arc. I don't know if I gave enough lead or not. That looks pretty good. Couple ricochets, couple pens, couple over pens. As a low tier ship, there's not much to expect from it, but it is for 240,000 free XP, so there has to be something. And I think the main thing with the ship is the amount of health. As you can see, the stock Congo only has 46,500. And as a base Tiger, you start off with 57,000. So you immediately have an advantage in health. You also have range. You also have the speed boost. So you're definitely not a ship to be ignored. You just don't have much that's special about you. Against destroyers, armor piercing still works, enough overpens, and you don't need to have high explosive. Secondary should finish her off, there she goes. Your secondaries are pretty accurate for this tier, but there will be quite a few salvos where you just entirely miss, but they will be relatively close around the ship. 13,000 on the Congo. And this is just how you play her. You keep her at range, keep a nice angle in case of enemy shoots back, because you don't have the maneuverability to react after they've shot. And you just look for broadsides. Now this Tiger is full health, it is kind of an angle, but you can still see that a couple pens, but you got some ricochets, so you're not entirely vulnerable to shells. You do ricochet quite a bit, a lot. You have this Leander. Not quite sure if I'll be able to hit. This Congo is about to be in range. Let's see if we can nail her from here. I highly doubt it, but it's worth a shot. She is in range. I'm actually pretty good. Let's see if the shells worked. I've got one pen. And I can switch over to high explosive to show you how high explosive is. But like I said, with the armor piercing, I just don't see the real need to use it. One pen. Congo's maneuvering, but instant fire. Now, the main threat at this tier is enemy battleships and carriers. Carriers, because of their torpedo bombers, can cause floods, which you can't repair necessarily as quick. And battleships, because of just how powerful their broadside ships or shots are. Cruisers, not very powerful. Most of them you can overmatch through the nose with armor piercing and citadel them. And destroyers, yes, they have torpedoes, but they have to come really close, and you'll be able to see them beforehand most of the time. So you can maneuver and shoot at them as well. Let me see if I can get four fires on her. We're going to switch back to armor piercing as well. Two fires. Four fires. Perfect. So I guess she could have use as a high explosive spammer. She's not terrible. And then armor piercing to finish the job. Hopefully we'll get a citadel. Pretty good accuracy. Still no citadel. And there we have a game. Really quick game. But that's usually what you have at the lower tiers. 90,000 damage. We didn't even break 100k. Two ships sunk. 49 shell hits. 6 fires. 2 defended caps. 1 secondary hit. The ship is not privy to a free XP bonus, since she is purchased with free XP. So you cannot use her to grind. All in all, I mean, there's nothing bad about this ship, but there's nothing that really stands out about the ship besides being the one, only one of her class historically, and having just a lot of health. And as you saw, she's not bad with high explosive, but her armor piercing is pretty good too when used adequately. I didn't really have a good chance to show that in that last battle. All in all, do I recommend her? I mean, if you want her, that's up to you. Like I said, she is pretty cheap at 240,000 for XP. If you play enough games, you can reach that in no time. And then you have your own ship. But, like I said, there's nothing special about her, and I don't honestly play her that often. So, you could definitely use the 240,000 free XP in better ways, I should say. You can save her up for one of the better free XP ships, like Missouri or Louisiana. So those are my top two recommended free XP ships. But there's nothing wrong with Tiger. With that, I will wrap up today's video. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you tomorrow. Take care.